What's he like before he goes on stage?
Well, he does a number of songs that I like very much. I think that trilogy, American Trilogy, that he's been doing on tour is one of the greatest things that he's done, you know, really.
Okay, after the introduction, and after you've done, what's that new song we just did?
For the good times.
Yeah.
And do
Burning
Love tonight?
You know, we throw this one in.
When we did it, nobody knew where to end it. You know.
I'm not saying anything. that was funny though, because you know, they had forgotten the ending, really. It was a hunk of burning love twice. Yeah, the drum run. I didn't do it. Tut went crazy, man. You know, immigration.
We got time for
it. We're good.
What you have done, I said, see, 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 right, oh, see, what you have done. Girl, you made me love you, and now your loving man is gone. What I say, well, I'm going away, baby, and I won't be back here for long. Going away, baby, and I won't be back here for long. If I find me a good girl, I won't be back at all. Hear what I say. Easy rider, oh see what you have done. I said see, easy rider, oh see what you have done. Well, you made me love you, and now you're never mad at all. When I said see, easy rider, I said see, easy rider.
Take it out, man.
I said see, easy rider. I said see. I said, see, he's here.
Thank you.
I feel.
Glory, glory, hallelujah.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. You're a fantastic audience. We're going to spring a new song on you tonight. We don't know it too well, but if we goof it up, just bear with us. We'll get it right. It may take a little while, but we'll get it right. Okay. Burning through to my soul, yeah. Girl, 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 you're gonna set me on fire. My brain is flaming and I don't know which way to go. Your kisses lift me higher like the sweet song of a choir, and you light my morning sky with burning love. Temperature rising, yeah. Heavenly, I'm flaming. It must be 109. Hell, burning, burning, burning. Nothing can cool me, cool me, cool me. I just might turn into flames, but I feel fine. Yeah. But your kisses lift me higher, like the sweet song of a choir. Flames and a lick in my body. Please won't you help me? I feel like I'm slipping away. It's hard to breathe. My chest is a heaving. Help me, I'm burning a hole where I lay. Yeah. Cause your kisses lift me high, like the sweet song of a choir. And you light my just a hunk of burning love. I'm just a hunk of burning love. I'm just a hunk of burning love. I'm just a hunk. I'm just a hunk of burning love. Hunk on, baby. That would never end, the blame thing. Thank you. You're a fantastic audience. Now, that's new, and we've never done it on stage before, so if we goofed up, I'm sorry. Anyhow.
Well, he came to Memphis to sing with a group called the Blackwood Brothers. It was the first time that I'd ever seen him.
How did you run into him this time? Just in Vegas?
I just realized that they were available. And he formed a new quartet called Stamps. And I listened to some of the records, and they had all this power.
Well, he made the Stamps, and he brought them together.
He put them together.
One of his nephew, and one of his son-in-law. The other two, I don't know where they came from.
But each one of the guys individually are good, as you can
oh, yeah,
see.
I noticed.
They all have good.
See, we come from a different background. We come from the Middle West or from the West Coast.
Yeah, you don't hear this too much.
Yeah. So we don't hear this. So we see a bunch of guys, and it has a whole different kind of level of meaning to us.
We grew up with it, you know, from the time I can remember, like 2 years old. I grew up with this because my folks took me there. And when I got old enough, I started to sing in church.
And that's how you got into singing? Or?
Well, it's one of the ways.
One of the ways. You know, yeah.
But I liked all type of music. You know, when I was in high school, I had records about Mario Lanza and the Metropolitan Opera. I loved music. The Spanish, I liked the Mexican flavored songs.
But this is so
music for you. But this thing here, the gospel thing is just, the gospel is really what we grew up with. More than anything else.
And there seems to be that
almost like every song.
It's a kind of a soul.
Yeah, like a
it comes from
way deep
inside.
Fantastic strength that's inside, yeah.
It just isn't singing notes. It's singing something that seems to come from very deep inside of you.
And at certain times, you push out and pull in. Just a part of you, you know, you think about it.
When I was in France about 3 or 4 years ago, and I was doing a film on Jean-Claude Keeley. And I asked him just offhand, who was his favorite singer? And he said, oh, he says, Elvis Presley. He's my man.
Really?
He's my man. He said,
well, he's my favorite skier.
And I asked him why.
That's nice.
And he said, he did this whole thing. He says, he has soul. You know it's hard for an American to talk to a Frenchman and understand that he understands soul better than you do. But he really does. He says, he sings, you know, from in here. And that was his way of describing. He had a very limited English at the time.
It's fantastic. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, and I, Johnny, saw a mighty number way up in the middle of the air.
Thank you very much. We'd like to do
a gospel song, ladies and gentlemen, that we did in 1966 called How Great Thou Art. And there proclaim
Tell them about it.
Colonel, can we get in there?
That's our newspaper man. Don't mess with him. Go in a little further, right?
Great shot, it was
can
back.
Can you see through here?
This, Colonel, this is impossible. I forgot his marker.
Hey,
Colonel.
I can't see him.
Tell him what you said. You tell him.
She's shy.
Thank
you.
Can you step back?
Just think about the song that you like. Or could you sing me a special song, please?
I sure will.
Don't cry, Daddy, or let me tender all, whichever
okay.
one you want.
Alrighty.
Or whichever one you
want.
Danny,
okay.
Look over here, honey. No, look at it. Look at Elvis. Okay.
Okay, smile. I'm not going to tell you which one I'm going to do, okay? I'm
just
surprised.
The special one. What's your favorite song?
Oh, a surprise, Danny?
There you go.
Oh.
Okay. How about it?
Oh!
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Bye-bye, you.
Bye.
You
thank you.
You happy now? Her arms are about to fall out.
Move these people out, please.
Calm down.
Where have you found the guys? I mean, we know about JD, but like the other guys who are in the chorus. It seems like you've known them forever, just watching you around the piano and singing, like you're like real super old friends from a long, long time.
Well, like I said, I knew JD from back when I was 15 years old, when he first came to Memphis to sing with a group called the Blackwood Brothers. And I was a big gospel music fan, so they would sing all night. And I would stay there all night, you know. And he had formed this new group himself a couple years ago. And I just heard their records and put them together with the inspirations and everything else that we had. Looked in the gutter, man, and dug them out.
All of that's going on the stage, yeah. It's really...
But then when you put it all together,
it seems to be a kind of like a relationship going on stage. It's like everybody is a friend of everybody else on stage. And that's something very rare, because we've seen a lot of groups perform and don't get that kind of feeling.
Well, I think it's because we enjoy it, you know. And we constantly enjoy it, which means that we do two shows a night for 5 weeks, but we never let it get old. Every song is like we do it for the first time, and that's one of the secrets, you know.
Well, like it's not a planned thing. You don't do the songs, the same songs, the same sequence.
Not necessarily. Yeah, we can change them around, but even if we do the same songs, they're new, and the sound is you know, the feeling is there every time.
But it's a different feeling each time, right?
It's a good feeling.
It's a
good feeling. We never let it down. Because there's a new audience out there. Plus, we enjoy what we're doing.
Well, Elvis communicates with us, really. I mean, you really do from the stage. I've sung with a lot of people, but he has some way of of keeping you interested and communicate in between you and him. And,
I'm not going to tell you how.
You aren't going to tell us the secrets? Well, hell, we'll get out.
Things are going behind my back and they should, no. but we will, we'll keep it interested, or interesting somehow, you know.
Hope it's more
interesting. 5 weeks,
been.
Man.
Oh, shut up. At the end of the 5 weeks, it was, you know, it went by like that. And it seemed like a day.
Well, see, like, I don't know. For instance, this evening, I know you were running just through everything just for us, for the cameras, what have you. Which would seem like if you did the reverse on us and said, well, guys, just walk around with your cameras like you normally do in the concert, would be a drag to us because it would be hard for us to get up to that level. But what's hard for us to figure out is that you can turn it on here just like you do on the stage.
Well, you know what's interesting about music and about all the people here, they find new sounds, you know, and they do things differently themselves. So it's like a new experience every day. The guy on the guitar will find a new lick, or the guy on the piano will find something, or the voices will add something, you know. And I hear all this, and it inspires me. Yeah.
Because, like, we watch, it's new for us, we're watching things like you and the lead guitarist kind of looking, the looks that go back and forth, and we're lining up shots. There's, like, really something going on, some sort of magic. I mean, we know already the game that goes on with Charlie Hodges and the kidding, the back and forth, and that's part of it, too. So there's a kind of thing going on there, there's something going on there. I notice when your eye goes over to JD when the chorus comes in, you know, each one of them is like a little turn-on, you know. It's like a conversation. It goes on each one, but there's surprises.
It's like a
that.
Feedback.
Yeah. It's a back and forth, back and you're forth. Turning each other on.
Well, that's what I mean. I mean, it never ceases. It goes on.
See, and that's what we're looking for in the film. That's what the film has to explore totally. It's that whole electricity, you know, that's just kind of circulating back and forth.
I hope you find it.
Hey, it's not. Well, I went to tell you, we looked and it wasn't there.
Thanks.
So we're wrapping. Hey, let's call it a night.
Gotta rest up for the road.
That was.
I don't want to. He's one of the biggest
restrooms I've ever been in.
Well, so I think it's sort of intimate, you know?
This is a little bigger than the auditorium.
There's only three people in the auditorium.
It's selling.
That's how we sold it out.
You know what?
That's good.
John Wayne keeps his cufflinks in a place like that.
Yeah,
go ahead.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
That's an excellent idea.
Star. Right. You could be the wettest star or a drift.
Hester Williams.
It's a room of two.
Room's not big enough for both of us, right? I got a
friend up here. Oh, we got plenty of room now.
You got a hair dryer, Delta?
No.
Good on my.
It's an oversized Hester Williams.
Get my voice ready here.
What a glass do you have?
Don't waste that stuff, Jerry.
No, I'm
well,
it's
checking it.
As a result,
no,
but I'd like to show.
Go stand in front of your lights, huh? Hope the sound system like it was last time. Speak to the front. What kind of engines are straight up? Straight up, we're about seven turns and twists.
It's on the air. Turn it down.
Slate
insulation. I can hear my feet.
I'm not bleeding.
Mine too.
Thanks for
bowling. I go back to hotels now.
Nothing comes out.
If you do not have a ticket, please do not attempt to enter the lobby. It is necessary that everyone hold their own ticket, which must be shown to the police officers at the lobby door.
Program, right here, Mr. Elm.
Officer Doyle, $2.
Hey, Friday!
All ticket holders with the word printed on the ticket, please use the escalators for the upper level.
Changed, Elvis?
I don't think so. You know, I think I see people of all different ages and things out there, you know. And if I do something good, you know, they let me know. If I don't, they let me know that. Like, for a while, it was a theory that anything I did would sell and so forth. Well, I knew that was not true. It's according to the material. You got to have good material. Whether it's a song, a script, or whatever, it's got to be good. Or it's a give and take proposition in that. They give me back the inspiration and
kind of a circular thing.
Sure.
You give them something.
Sure. I work absolutely to them, whether it's 6 or 6,000, it doesn't really matter. It's just they bring it out of me, the inspiration, the ham.
If you go out there some night, sure. And say you're in 4 or 5 tunes and it just isn't coming back from the audience, what do you do?
I change the songs around. I'll go back and stay up all night working on it, you know, worrying about it. I'll find out what it is. It's not, because it's very important, you know.
Do you ever play to one particular person in the audience? Do you ever single out, say, a girl that's on the side of the stage? Play to her?
That's difficult because of the lighting.
So
I can't hardly see them, you know. I can see them, but not in detail. You know?
You count the flashbulbs.
I will play off of an isolated incident, say, if somebody is really jumping them down or yelling or enjoying.
I'm going to be there in about 5 minutes.
Hey.
That's Gator.
Hey, there's the king.
Did the launch chair go off?
Yeah. You could see that. You could see it
in
the sky
when
it disconnected up there. Gigi and saw the explosion. I didn't know it.
I had launch.
Because they just launched right over here.
I had launch. I was buried in a beaver.
Oh! How was your launch?
No, they don't have sound working, man.
Who do you want to
bench?
Right, they don't have sound.
Feel
a little bit now.
They do?
No, it's just they don't have sound.
It's just picture.
Oh, is it?
Just picture. Just picture.
Just picture.
They got sound taped in here, ain't they?
You sneaky.
That's why I want to say no. I know I wanted to know.
Okay.
Yeah. They believe that section out right there.
Well, you got to do a 5-minute monologue over this.
What a friend we have in Jesus.
5-minute monologue to cover it, man.
What a friend we have in the editor.
Hey,
Hey, let's call it a night.
Got to rest up for the road.
Mm. Got a big
jump from here to
Buffalo
or wherever.
You're not a dream. You're not an angel. You're a woman. I'm not a king. Just a man. Take my hand. We'll make a space in this life that we plan. And we will stay till it's time for you to go. Yes, we're different, worlds apart, we're not the same. We laughed and played at the start, like in a game. Oh, you could have stayed outside my heart, but if you came, and we will stay till it's time for you to go. Has no end. I was an oak, now I'm a willow, and I can bend. Oh, and though I'll never in my life see you again, here I'll stay till it's time for you to go. Oh, yes, I'll stay till it's time for you to go.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Take it on, Jerry.
Waiting.
It's one more. Burning love, light my mournful. Burning love, burning love. I'm just a hunk of burning love. Now one more burning love in it. Okay, let's do it again. Faded on stage.
Well, like patch it up.
Let's feel, keep it in a high note.
We'll blow the curtain.
Just like patch it up.
Keep on turning, proud man.
Not too often. When you're working every night there.
I mean, what does it do for you? I mean, to get into this, is it like a
I think it more or less puts your mind at ease. It does mine. You know, because you've been really concentrating and everybody's been working out. So these things we know.
It's like old friends.
Right. And it puts your mind at ease. It
takes you down
to a level. Otherwise, you'd go out of here just and you couldn't sleep for, you know. There's nothing wrong with it, but. Mm. If you ended on a real fast up-tempo song or something, you know, we leave the studio. Nobody can sleep for hours.
You're right, though. When you leave the stage like a place like Vegas, you're really up. You're really, really flat.
It takes at least 4 or 5 hours to even begin to unwind. And we usually wind up, you know, doing this type of stuff.
I like to sing. If you can reach me, honey, I'll be glad to. Just take your time and don't get hurt. Take your time. Okay. Back job. Don't look.
You know, how do the one-night stands feel? I mean, city.
Oh, that's exciting. Just the traveling around and going to the shows and
so a piece of
and having them say, "Oh, I knew you from 50 years ago," and I wasn't around 50 years ago.
So hush, little baby, don't you cry. You know your daddy's bound to die.
Thank you. You're really fantastic. Thank you very much.